border to a breakaway state. Welcome to Transnistria. Well, not quite. As NATO worries this may be Moscow's next target for invasion, pro-Russian officials here are barring curious foreign journalists.
So we've got through the border now, the third time of trying. Our cover story here was that we were going to a miniskirt competition, which is being staged at one of the local nightclubs tonight.
Driving past old apartment blocks and rundown factories, it's clear Transnistria needs more than a miniskirt to give it glamour. Fedor Ilyich's sad Russian song says, "I've no home to go to and nobody to love me." That could be the anthem of Transnistria. It's a land in limbo, recognised by no sovereign nation. A land that still lives under the hammer and sickle.
Stalin tut.
Where folk at this flea market still hanker after the glory days of the Cold War.
Of course it was good with the Soviet Union. We wanted to be with Russia and still want to be with Russia.
It's a land where Lenin rises like a guardian angel. This is at the heart of one of Russia's so-called frozen conflicts, those were unresolved political and territorial disputes that NATO chiefs fear Moscow could reignite in a bid to once again expand its influence across the region. Even if Russian tanks do roll in, it wouldn't be much of an invasion. Locals say they'd welcome it.
Here, people are all for it. If the Russian military comes, they'll all cry, hooray!
Students Katya and Sergei, more focused on love, not war, say they'll head to Russia for work when they graduate.
If the Russians come, it won't be a tragedy. The Russian military is already here.
When the Soviet Union collapsed, Transnistria waged a war to split from Moldova. Russian soldiers stepped in to stop the fighting. They still man bases and checkpoints here. In the countryside, Anna Ivana thinks closer ties with Russia will bring economic benefits like cheaper energy and better pensions.
Why do we need Europe? It's good for us to be with Russia.
Transnistrians have repeatedly called to join the Russian Federation. If Moscow now decides to welcome them, no need for an invasion like NATO warns. Just read the writing on the wall.
Is this simply about star-crossed lovers or perhaps a sign of the political times? I love you so, but why I love you, I never know. A message to Russia with love.
Carl Penhall, CNN, Tiraspol, Transnistria.